Lincoln Riley's coaching staff is set, and we're going to talk about what that means for Oklahoma in 2019, and all that's coming up after the bumper.
What do you mean you don't subscribe to my son's YouTube channel?
Mama, no!
Just snap the damn ball, RJ.
What's up, kid folk? It's RJ Young. I am not on a step mill. Consider hitting the like and subscribe button because I upload a video every single day. It's always OU related, college football related, sports related. We have a good time. And today, we're going to talk about Lincoln Riley's coaching staff for the 2019 season. To look at this with the naked eye is to see a bunch of guys that Mike Leach hired, and Mike Leach got jobs. And if you haven't listened to my interview with Mike Leach, I encourage you to do so. It's very, very insightful, and there are lots of hints. But check this out. Over the last couple of days, Lincoln Riley solidified his staff with an inside linebackers coach in Brian Odom, native of Oklahoma, and Roy Manning, who's coming from UCLA by way of Washington State, to coach cornerbacks. This means that Alex Grinch will coach safeties and be the defensive coordinator. Ruffin McNeil will be the defensive end outside linebackers coach, and Calvin Thibodeau will be your defensive line coach. I love this staff just because not of the experience, but the energy. Now, for those of you that follow me on Twitter, you can see that I was tweeting out a bunch of Roy Manning videos. The man uploads himself to his Twitter feed, which makes him a must-follow already. And I am so begging for this man to be mic'd up during spring ball and in the preseason because he just looks like a joy. But more than that, Roy Manning coached outside linebacker special teams at UCLA. You know who else was over there? Jalen Phillips. Jalen Phillips was a top recruit in 2017, and Roy Manning helped get him there. And I really like adding Brian Odom and Roy Manning to the staff because, number one, you give Alex Grinch a couple guys that know how he does things and help him install the 3-4 defense he wants to run. And number two, Brian Odom, I believe, was not just brought in for energy and to be another guy that knows Grinch's system, but to not lose another battle in the state of Oklahoma. I think Brian Odom secretly is your weapon to bring into the household of Dax Hill, of Josh Proctor, of the number one recruit in the state because of his social cachet and influence in Oklahoma. Not just having won a national championship at Oklahoma and been a pretty great high school football player, and then Houston, and then Washington State, and then Missouri, but a guy for which dads will know. You could walk into that dad's living room as Brian Odom and be like, yeah, Ada, what's up? State player of the year, what's up? I'm All-State, what's up? And your kid would have to listen because dad's over there going, no, you're going to listen to what Brian Odom has to say because this dude was kicking my behind in high school and he wants you to come to Oklahoma, and Oklahoma ain't no slouch. Now, I understand that the recruiting power around this program has always been pretty, I say always, the last 3 years, since Lincoln Riley's taken over, it's been pretty good. It's been pretty stout. Oklahoma's getting guys that other people just want. The issue is talent development. Now, we know just by looking at the resumes of this staff on both sides of the ball that they can recruit like all get out. Cale Gundy, Dennis Simmons, Bill Beatonbowl, Lincoln Riley. Everywhere you look, from Shane Beamer all the way through to the head coach, you got guys that can go out there and win recruiting battles. Now, we're going to get to see if they can develop the talent that's already at Oklahoma and develop the kids that they're bringing in the 2020 class. And I think that was the real beef with a guy like Kerry Cooks. It's not that the dude couldn't recruit, because he got 5-star cornerback in Brendan Bukey Radley Hiles. He's already got a couple cornerbacks committed to the 2020 class before he left. And you got guys like Jamal Morris coming in, Jaden Davis coming in, Woody Washington. We know the man could recruit. It's a question about whether or not he could develop. Now, whether it be scheme, and I think it is, a lot of scheme, or just Kerry Cook's coaching, you didn't really see much out of the secondary when you get these guys in here that kind of stood pat. We're going to wait and see on Roy Manning just because he doesn't have a lot of experience coaching defensive backs. I mean, he's coached the cornerbacks at Michigan, but that was a while ago. He made his name as a linebacker at Michigan. He made his bones as a linebacker coach. But I think because Alex Grinch is back there with him, you're basically going to have a symbiotic relationship there where they work on each other. And Alex Grinch is a fiery dude, but Roy Manning is the fire itself. And I think with him back there, Justin Broyles back there, of course, you're going to have a lot of fireworks from the defensive backs, and I think that's good. You need those guys cranked to a million, because asking a kid to play cornerback in college is asking a kid to play at a disadvantage forever, which is why when folks say things like, and I need to do a thing I hate about this, you need to go get these 6'3", 6'4" cornerbacks, I go, yeah, okay, You're going to tell that wide receiver, hey, I want you to play defensive back. I want you to play at a disadvantage. I want you to not know what route you're running. I want you to have to react to everything, and I want you to be mossed at least twice a year. Because check this out. The only guy I wasn't was Champ Bailey, and he's an actual alien. Other than that, everybody gets beat if they play defensive back, just the way that it is. So you need a guy back there that's going to constantly be picking them up and teach them the best technique to play. Now, I watched a lot of Washington State tape, 2015, 2017, when Alex Grinch was there. I'm going to tell you, DBs still play off. They run the similar 3-4 scheme. They got this rush defensive end that stands up like a jack linebacker. Looks a lot like Mike Stoops' scheme, but they play one gap, which is a big difference. I don't know that they play a lot of press, but, you know, Pac-12, we'll see. I wouldn't hold my breath on a just overhaul of the scheme. I think Alex Grinch really loves coaching this 3-4 that's multiple and can get in, get out of. They'll run 5 DBs. They'll run 4 DBs. But I also think this is an issue where you might see Buki move back to corner. And I think that would be really cool, too, because I think a guy like Roy Manning speaks Buki's language. I think he's going to just keep that kid cranked up, and he'll want to play. And that's understated. What's understated is wanting to play for your position coach, wanting to go lights out. I want to go lights out for my boss because my boss has my back. Because my boss says, hey, RJ, I hired you because I believe in you. I believe in what you're capable of doing. I believe in your talent. And I believe in letting you be RJ, letting you do it the way you need to do it as long as you get results. And I love that. And I think that's what you're getting with a guy like Roy Manning and Brian Odom to a degree, and especially Alex Grinch. I think they're just going to get behind this team, raise them up, and show them the way that they need to go. We're going to see if they can develop. There's going to be a couple years where we're going to get to see that, and we hope to see something real soon. Won't really know anything until about October of 2019, but I have faith, and you should too. All right, that's it for me. Deuces.